Greetings, fellow ukulelians. Jeff Weinberger coming at you here with a new ukulele tutorial. Today I'd like to continue our discussion of how to practice ukulele. And this time we're going to talk about song learning. How do you encounter songs and how do you take them in? How do you memorize them, etc., etc.? So what I was just doing was a cold reading. That's what I call it. When I open up a songbook like I have here, I have this songbook that was given me to me by a friend. And it came from New Jersey. There was a cover band in New Jersey. I'm not sure the name of the band, but she was good friends with them, and she gave me this songbook that they used to use way back in the 80s to play hundreds and hundreds of songs. It's a thick book. This is page 89, and it's Yellow Goodbye Yellow Brick Road by Elton John, a song I have never played before in my life. You could probably tell from my sloppy performance. I was just reading it off of the song sheet. When you encounter a song for the first time, there's some things you want to look at, some things you want to survey and check out and make sure that you understand. So I looked at the song and I said, oh, it's in the key of G. I see one sharp in the key signature. It says moderately slow in two. I knew it was going to be slow. I mean, I grew up with this song, so I know basically what it's supposed to sound like. And then I saw the first chord was A minor, and I just went for it. I did a cold reading. That was not rehearsed. I had never played this song in my life, but I just read through it. And a couple of those chords took me by surprise. So don't be surprised if you, when you're reading through a song, every once in a while have to stop. I tried not to stop. I just kept going as if I knew the song well. But like I said, I've never played this song before in my life. So in learning this song, I saw it was in the key of G. I saw they wanted a slow, moderately slow two feel. And then I just picked a strum. I just instinctively went to. That was down, 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 up, down, 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 up. That kind of gave me what I thought would be an appropriate feel for the song. And then I saw it was A minor. It was D. It was G. That's a 2-5-1 in G. I'm very familiar with that chord progression. It's not a big deal. So I was able to handle that. It goes to C in the fourth measure. This is all standard stuff, 2-5-1-4, one of the most common progressions in all of Western music. I'll play that for you so you can hear it. When are you gonna come down? When are you gonna learn? Not rocket science necessarily. And then it goes F to D7. Stayed on the farm. I should have listened to my old man. That's standard stuff. It's nothing earth-shattering. But then in the next line, I saw, A minor 7. That's different than A minor. I did that. And then very quickly, within one beat, it changes to C, so you have to go. Gotta be on your toes to catch that. So if I were learning this song and wanting to perform it tonight at a club or something, I would take note of that. I might even highlight it with my highlighter that it changes very quickly to C there. I survey through it. I look for chords I know. I look for chords I don't know. I'm cool with F. I know D7. I know G. Oh, but look at that. It does an unexpected twist. It went to E flat. That almost took me by surprise, but I kept my composure and didn't fumble it. That line. Friends too open, boys too young to be singing. So that, boys too young to be singing, the blue, that E flat might take you by surprise. Then there's an F7, B flat, back to E flat. So those aren't earth-shattering chords either. Those are pretty normal chords in the key of E flat, but you would have had to anticipate that the song changes key. It went from the basic key of G to the key of E flat. That's a radical key shift right there. Elton John was very, and still is, very inventive with that sort of thing. He makes it sound effortless. So let me try to make that sound effortless.